first phase was actually the panels on the outside of the building. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Hi, I'm Allison Lovejoy, interviewing Peter Fitzsimmons, Executive Director of the West Coast Jazz Heritage Center. Hello, how are you today?
I'm good, Allison. Welcome to the Lush Life Gallery, Jazz Heritage Center, which would serve to honor the legacy of this Fillmore district and the jazz legends that played up and down the street when this was the mecca of the jazz district back in the 40s and 50s,
the clubs, the
Harlem of the West, yeah. Bop City, Club Alabama, the Plantation, Texas Long Bar, Minnie's Can Do Club. I mean, I could just go on. There was like 20 or 30 night spots, hot spots, yeah, up and down, mm-hmm, Fillmore, where all the greats would come and play. And when I say all the greats, I'm talking about the residential legends, John Handy as a young man, my dad, F. Allen Smith, Mary Stallings, and then the nationally known legends, Miles Davis, Duke Ellington, Billie Holiday. They all came through the Fillmore. They all dressed elegantly, and it was an era of the cool. And our opening exhibit is called Jazz Genesis, San Francisco's Birth of Jazz. This exhibit is going to locate and substantiate with information that we've uncovered with our help from John Templeton, our historian, where he's dug around the San Francisco background of jazz and has come up with late 1800s jazz clubs existing in the Barbary Coast. He's come up with names of the people that were running these clubs and how they lived in this neighborhood and dealt in this neighborhood. He's come up with the first actually credentialed newspaper article coining the word jazz. This predates some of the New Orleans stuff. So when we break out with these stories, we'll have some ways to substantiate these claims.
Reading a lot about the Fillmore history, you know, in that little dark phase where everything was kind of gentrified and people were missing what the heart of this area was.
Right.
Just walking into jazz clubs and hearing live performances. What do you see the future of this area?
Our wish is to create the rebirth of the cool. These are slogans, they're campaigns, but they're also our passion. I want to hook up with the Smithsonian and just do a small percentage of what they have and display that history, not only just the Fillmore, but reach out to the New Orleans jazz history, the New York, the Kansas City, all the hot spots of jazz. We want to tell the whole evolution of jazz in this jazz heritage. In order to complete the interactive displays, what I call the high ticket items, the video wall, the touchscreen technology, the content, the rights to talk about the 350 plus legends of jazz that we want to honor, we need to raise, I would say, about $1.5 million. The Correct Foundation was our first major contributor, so we're really, really proud about that. Situation here, this is the door to the screen. Very pricey, elegant, plush screen down there, and at one point almost was that close to a donation of a Dusseldorf from Deanna Bolsendorf. Thank you.
I know it's kind of, it's part of the bigger picture, and I always think that way. You know, it's not just about music. It's appropriate that Yoshi's would be the place to do it because they are a Bay Area institution.
It's ironic,
yeah,
too, because then we also have the connect, which I'm trying to do in the Jazz Heritage Center, which I also didn't talk about, is the multicultural contributions that will be part of my timeline, that will be part of my kiosk, that talks about the Japanese internment and the stories back in the day. Even before that, we're looking at 1906 earthquake when the Russian Jews populated up and down the street,
right,
and brought this, yeah, Fillmore was like the main street, it was, yeah, like the market street, mm-hmm, after the earthquake. So I want to connect all those dots as well and tell all of that story. So the Japanese connection with Yoshi's being here and the Asian connection, it just seems natural. I wanted to stop here so you can see this lovely bar.
That's beautiful.
Cool ass hangout.
I'll be visiting it tomorrow night after the show.
Tremendous. The huge restaurant,
yes,
which just got the rave review. Gentrification issue is huge.
Yeah.
You look at the Mission, you look at other areas that have experienced that.
Well, thanks for meeting with us. We'll send you the link. I have your card with
Sweet.
Your email on
Sweet.
It. That's what